Welcome back, Nick and Lex here. Thank you so much for being here to another video of Metal with Nick. So I'm gonna correct a video that I did for Eric Meredith by Hum. For some reason, I did the whole intro and the whole dedication. I'm so sorry, Eric. And but I did post a different song. So the song that I actually posted was by the band. I was gonna do that afterwards by the band Eldritch. And what I did, I posted the song, as you everybody I guess already knows, was No Obscurity. So okay, but this is gonna be definitely the right one. This is gonna be by Hum. Let's see. And this is the Isle of the Cheetah. So this is the definite video. I'm gonna take my glasses off because this is what happens when you become short-sighted, I guess. You know, you mess up on the videos. So new reaction. So I thought I heard Hum, but it was it was Eldritch. So never mind. There's an extra video now, which is great. That's dedicated to Eric, but this is the definite one. Thank you, Eric, for choosing this. Like I said, I have no idea what Hum is. Now, they did say it was alternative. Eldritch sounded also kind of alternative to me, but it was more like progressive. That's why I put like progressive alternative in like the thumbnail. But I guess it's more like an alternative band. So here we go with Hum, Isle of the Cheetah from the album Downward Is Heavenward. So here we go. Definitely different.
Nice.
cool. Like, it's definitely has that vibe, that 98, 99, 2000 vibe. Like, I remember back in those days when I was still like learning how to play the guitar, and I had all these friends that were getting into music and playing. So we would get together almost, well, not every day, but every 2-3 days, and just like have a couple of beers, you know. That's when I was still drinking, I guess. And we would just like jam. Like, the drummer was just like learning how to play. I was learning how to play. So we did like power chords, and we just like jam like just alternative music. Like, almost, it's not very technical, but it was very like, and some guy would just make up lyrics on the spot. Very talented guy. I remember them so well. I'm not a Facebook dude, so I don't really keep up with friends from like high school and stuff. But man, those were good times, really. And it was just like sounding also very like thick and just like a wall of sound, you know. I really like this. I really like it. Eric has a very good taste. Like, you know, like he liked a lot of Porcupine Tree, Steven Wilson, but he always comes out with stuff that's very, I was surprised, the Eldritch one, that was very good, and I was like, yeah, that's Eric right there, being more like technical prog, but this is more like him, like the stuff that he usually requests. But thank you, Eric, this is really cool. I'm sure like Alexia's gonna love this as well. This is more her timeline as well. But I just like, it brought me back to those jamming days where you would just like not play any solo. It was just like chords that you would strum, you know, up the neck and just create like this wall of sound. Really cool. I'm really digging this a lot. And sorry so much about the mistake, but I had these all lined up and, you know, it happens. But thank you. Thank you, Eric. Let's keep going. Let's see what else they have for us. This is really interesting. I love when something is not so technical. Sometimes it's just like, you know, straight up alternative rock. But this is more metal. It sounds very metal. Very cool. Yeah, it does remind me a little bit, you know, of the days, like, I mean, this was like after Nirvana had already like basically stopped, like Pearl Jam, you know, like all those great bands, like Soundgarden. We had Soundgarden, we had man, what else did I listen to? Stone Temple Pilots. What else? I mean, there's so many bands. Weezer, I guess. And the whole, like, alternative wave, like Foo Fighters came afterwards a little bit. But yeah, 98 is, that's when metal had a very, very odd change, when the new metal scene came on. This is not new metal. This sounded more like alternative, like almost grungy, you know, really cool. And I was still listening, of course. I was just getting into, like, at that time in 1998, I was literally getting into Metallica and Iron Maiden, but my friends were more like going with the current. So they were into the Peppers and all the new bands like Offspring and like the stuff that was coming out. So I had to like kind of like when we were jamming, I couldn't be like, dun, 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 you know, so I had to kind of like jam. And it was a lot of fun just like playing like open chords and just like power chords. And just like when I would start to solo, and it would look at me like, what are you doing? You know, so, yeah, a lot of fun. So definitely cool band, Hum. Thank you, Eric, for the request. I apologize for the mistake that I did earlier. Maybe you didn't even notice. I posted a wrong song with the name of Hum. And, of course, the comment section saved me. So thank you guys for that. And, guys, like and subscribe to the channel, please, if you can. It does help out. If you would like to request a song, you can do so as well. And... thank you so much. Alexia and I were still working on a couple of videos tonight and yesterday, also for the Patreon. So check that out as well if you want to. But thank you so, so much for being here, checking this out. I did have a lot of fun. It's a really cool band that I'm going to check out further. And like I said, this is right down like Alexia's alley when it comes to like rock or metal. She's more about like, I don't know, she's into different stuff. She's not so much about the falsetto and the solos and all that stuff. She's more into like thick walls of sound like this. So thank you so much for being here, and we'll see you in the next one. Take care.